For 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge. Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
And thank you again, everybody, and welcome to another game of a Granite State Challenge. We have moved nicely through our opening round of competition. As a matter of fact, only this week and next week remain, and we'll have our first round of play all completed. 14 teams have already won games to move into the second round. Two schools playing tonight, the winner also to advance to our second round of competition. Before we get to the game, let me just take a moment to remind you to visit our website where you can sign up as an alum and register as an alum of Granite State Challenge. We've heard from many of you, like to hear from all of you out there, so take the time to do that. And while you're there, you can view and download any of our programs from this season or last season, doing it through both YouTube or through the iTunes Music Store. So check it all out, won't you? All right, let's take a look at the teams, or introduce you to the teams playing in today's game. First of all, we have the team from Hollis-Brookline High School, enrolling about 945 students and located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Joey Perricone, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Pat McDaniel, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Dylan King, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Daniel Michon, and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Christopher Saito, and his alternates are Caroline Quieri and Trevor Nierendorf, and they are the Cavaliers of Hollis-Brookline High School. So that's our first team. Now let's meet their opponents for tonight's game. They come to us from Merrimack Valley High School, enrolling about 875 students and located in New Hampshire's Merrimack County.
Hi, my name's Newell Moser, and I'm a senior.
Hi, my name's Benjamin Tasker, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Abby Lance, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Margaret Jones, and I'm a senior.
Also with us for the program, the coaches for the team, they are Kathleen Graham and Brett Thompson. They are the pride of Merrimack Valley High School. One last introduction, as we do each week, and that's to let you know who our judges are. This week, they are Mary Riley Potter and Ann Belanger. And as always, we thank them for their help. All right, we're ready to go into round number one. This is our 10-point toss-up round. We'll get on to our bonus round and 60-second round a little bit later on in the program. Right now, though, Hollis-Brookline and Merrimack Valley, these are 10-pointers. Good luck. Since much of New York City was built about 100 years earlier, its streets and buildings are crumbling, fulfilling the warnings of a former city commissioner, sometimes compared to which character of fable who warned that the sky was falling? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Penny Penny.
Merrimack Valley. Abby.
Chicken Little.
Chicken Little is right for the 10 points. Sir Alexander Fleming discovered penicillin in 1928. Spell penicillin. Dan of Hollis-Brookline.
E-E-N-I-C-I-L-L-I-N.
You got them all. That is correct for the 10 points. Well done. Here we go for another 10-pointer. What word designates both the force that causes a ball hit with a bat to come to a stop or a conflict between people? Abby of Merrimack Valley.
Inertia.
Hollis-Brookline. Joe.
Gravity.
It is friction. Here we go. Paper and pencil in front of you if you think you might need it for this game, for this question. Find the two numbers whose sum is 11 and whose difference is 15. Find the two numbers. Dan of Hollis-Brookline.
15 and negative 4.
Merrimack Valley. It is 13 and negative 2. Identify the country whose inhabitants are called Aussies. Dylan of Hollis-Brookline.
Australia.
That's easy enough. Well done for 10 points. Which musical instrument whose predecessor is the sackbut? Dan of Hollis-Brookline.
Trombone.
Well done for 10 points. It's the trombone. Now for 10 points. Who was the author of the following line? When angry, count four. When very angry, swear. Margaret of Merrimack Valley.
Benjamin Franklin.
He might have. Hollis-Brookline. Joe?
Mark Twain.
It was Mark Twain from Pudd'nhead Wilson. Nicely done. Which rare, colorless, and inert gas is known by the chemical symbol NE? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Neon.
Neon is right. What is the perimeter of a regular hexagon inscribed in a circle with a 9-inch radius? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
54 inches.
54 inches is correct. Where were U.S. hydrogen bombs tested back in 1954? Abbey of Merrimack Valley.
Nevada.
Hollis-Brookline, Dan.
Bikini Islands.
Judges, you'll take that. Bikini Islands, Bikini Atoll, that is correct for 10 points. Which name identifies both a variety of a hybrid perennial rose and a 1999 film starring Kevin Spacey and Annette Bening? Joe of Hollis-Brookline.
American Beauty.
American Beauty, well done for another 10 points. Still in round number one. On test forms for the U.S. Census in 2000, some whites, such as those born of Irish and Italian parents, erroneously labeled themselves with the new trial category multiracial. Which word, beginning with multi, is a label for a white person born of Irish and Italian parents? The word we were looking for was multi-ethnic. Our galaxy's cloud of interstellar matter originated in an explosion 2 to 3 million years ago near which star, the largest and brightest in Scorpio? It's named for a rival of Aries, the Greek god of war. Newell of Merrimack Valley.
Sirius?
Good try, Hollis-Brookline. Patrick?
Rigel?
It is Antares. Paper and pencil once again in front of you. Find the ratio of 80 seconds to 8, I'll try it again. Find the ratio of 80 seconds to 8 minutes as a fraction in lowest terms. We want Joe of Hollis-Brookline.
1/6.
1/6, well done. And there we go with another 10-point toss-up. We want you to name the capital city hit in 1999 by its first earthquake in nearly a century, a 5.9 magnitude quake that killed more than 100 people. Dylan of Hollis-Brookline.
Tokyo.
I can repeat it for Merrimack Valley. We want you to name the capital city hit in 1999 by its first earthquake in nearly a century, a 5.9 magnitude quake that killed more than 100 people but spared the towering columns of the Temple of Zeus. Abby?
Athens.
Athens is right for your 10 points. Now for another 10-pointer. Identify the two-word Latin term for the device Dutch artist Vermeer was thought to have used consisting of a dark chamber with a lens through which, Dylan of Hollis-Brookline.
Chiaroscuro.
Camera obscura is correct for the 10 points. Well, you have about a minute to go in our opening round. Give the term derived from Greek history that describes people who are simple, frugal, or austere. Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Spartan.
Spartan is correct. A plant cell has a non-living coat called a cell wall. Name the complex carbohydrate, Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Cellulose.
Well done. Cellulose that makes up the cell wall. Let's go one more paper and pencil in this round. What is the simplified form of the square root of 54? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
3 root 6.
3 times the square root of 6 is, again, correct via 10 points. And there's the sound ending our round. Well, it's Hollis-Brookline getting an early lead here in the game over Merrimack Valley. But we have a big bonus round just ahead that we'll get to momentarily. Before we get there, though, we are going to take a time out, ask Tim Estilos to join us, as he does each and every week. He talked to the team members prior to the program. Let's find out what was said when he talked with the team from Hollis-Brookline.
We're here with the team from Hollis-Brookline High School, home of the Cavaliers. Joe is the team captain. Now, you're a musician. What kind of instruments do you play?
I play the drums, the piano, the guitar occasionally. But I most like arranging sequences on my computer. And I play my music very loudly and drive my family crazy.
And every family loves when that happens. You also play golf quite a bit. Tell me about that.
That's right. And funny story, I was at a par 3 one time, and I was actually struck on the head by a golf ball while waiting to tee off.
The man had his own Caddyshack moment. Now, Patrick here. Patrick, you do all kinds of things. You are, first of all, are involved with physics. That's one of your favorite subjects. Tell me about that.
Yes, I enjoy it. I've always enjoyed math, but I haven't really been able to learn physics until very recently, and I found I love it. It ties in real phenomena in the real world with the problem-solving aspect of math, and it just interests me.
You design things as well on the computer. Tell me about that one thing you designed.
Yes, there's a CAD program that I used 2 years ago, and I designed a golden toilet on that program.
Ah, so you know that you've made it when you have a golden toilet in your house. Now, Dylan over here, Dylan is not on the basketball team despite his great impressive height, but you are on the drama club. Tell me about that.
Well, I find that it's a great way to apply yourself after school and potentially waste 3 hours.
Which is always fun, yes. But what kind of things do? You act or work
acting,
behind the
yes,
scenes?
Acting.
A little bit of acting.
Yes, acting.
Ah, acting. And also you study Russian a little bit.
Oh, yes. Well, it began out of my frustration, a rather geeky frustration of being unable to read Tolstoy and Dostoevsky in the original. So I've embarked on my project last summer, and I'm intending to continue it.
And if the Cold War starts again, you'll be in fine shape. Now, over here, we have Daniel. Daniel, you study karate quite a bit.
Yes, I've actually been studying for 4 years by now, and I should be able to get my black belt next spring. And it requires a lot of discipline and a lot of effort, but I think in the end, it'll pay off, absolutely.
Sounds good. And he's also interested in filmmaking, so he hopes to be something like that someday. Right now, let's get back to the game. This is your team from Hollis-Brookline.
And you look at the team from Hollis-Brookline, and right now they have a lead after round number one, but we come to a big bonus round right now. We'll continue to ask the 10-point toss-up questions, but the team that gets the toss-up correctly has a chance at bonus points. So Hollis-Brookline, Merrimack Valley, good luck, and here we go. In which Pacific Ocean island country did a famous sea battle begin in Leyte Gulf on October 23rd, 1944? This battle put an end to the Japanese fleet as an offensive force. Dylan of Hollis-Brookline.
Which is Midway.
Merrimack Valley. Newell.
Hawaii.
It was the Philippines is the country we were looking for. Name George and Barbara Bush's presidential pooch, whose book earned over $889,000, Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Millie.
Millie's book by Barbara Bush. Well done. Let's go over to Hollis-Brookline. Joe, you're the team captain. You can talk to everybody up there. Choose from the longest time, famous phrases, or spelling bee. The longest time, famous phrases, or spelling bee.
We'll take famous phrases, please, Jim.
Let's go with the famous phrases. And Joe, again, you talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. 4 or 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following. Word completing the saying, blank hands make the devil's work.
No. Idle.
Idle is correct. Word completing the phrase, tarred and blank, designating the punishment used during the Revolutionary War.
Feathered.
Correct. Word completing the saying, if wishes were horses, blank would ride.
Beggars.
Well done. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. Let's go for a 10-pointer. Spell. Brouhaha. Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Brouhaha.
You got it again for another 10 points. So back to Hollis-Brookline we go. We're going to ask for the longest time. We're going to take the spelling bee out of there since you just did so. And we'll add common conversions and the plays the thing. The longest time, common conversions, or the plays the thing.
We'll take common conversions, please,
Common
Jim.
Conversions it will be. And simply said, we want you to identify the common fractions for each of the following. 60%.
3/5.
Correct. 80%.
4/5.
And 125%.
Yep. 5/4.
Or 1 1/4. We're going to give you a nice easy 15 points on the bonus right there. Here we go for 10 points. In the web world, for what does ISP stand? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Internet service provider.
You got another 10 points, correct. And back over to Hollis-Brookline we go for the longest time. The plays the thing, or we've got chemistry.
We'll take we've got chemistry,
we've
please.
We've got chemistry, he says with a great deal of enthusiasm. Answer each of the following concerning chemistry. The English physicist whose name beginning with B identifies the equation yielding interatomic distances in crystals.
Bohr?
It is Bragg. Number of grams of water formed by igniting 4.0 grams of hydrogen with 4.0 grams of oxygen. Number of grams of water formed by igniting 4.0 grams of hydrogen and 4.0 grams of oxygen.
4 1/4.
It is 4.5 grams. And the term beginning with the letter P that refers to the agreement among several measurements of the same quantity and reflects
precision.
Precision is right. Thank you. And we'll give you 5 out of the 15 on the bonus. All right, let's skip the next one. No, we won't. We'll go with the judges. 135 is a multiple of 1 and which other one-digit positive integers? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
3 and 9.
Merrimack Valley. Margaret.
5.
Well, you put them all together and you're both right. It's 3, 5, and 9. Here's another 10-pointer. No, it isn't. There's the sound ending our round, and it is Hollis-Brookline getting that early lead and adding to it in the bonus round, holding on to the lead at the break, but we'll get on to our 62nd round in just a moment. Right now, we take a timeout and ask Tim to step in once again, this time talking with the team members from Merrimack Valley High School.
This fine-looking group here is from Merrimack Valley High School. Newell is the team captain. You are into beekeeping. Now, how dangerous or tricky can that be?
Well, it's actually pretty exciting, but really they aren't that mean. I mean, they never sting you unless you hurt them. They're pretty fun. Mm-hmm. We love to take the honey, and it's really a learning experience for me and the bees because they're just another society, and it's fun to analyze them.
Very good. And you're also into scuba diving. You got certified not too long ago, right?
That's right. I went down to an island chain in near Aruba called Bonaire, where we went and did some scuba diving around a coral reef, and that's an exhilarating experience for sure.
Sounds good. Now over here, we have Benjamin. Benjamin, you're involved with working with a hospital as part of a community service, giving back to the community kind of thing.
Yeah.
Tell me about that. What do you do with the hospital?
I file papers and help out the community through filing those papers.
Mm-hmm. And some of the other things that you do, I understand that you're involved with, or you used to be involved with Kempo. What is that?
It's a type of karate.
Mm-hmm. And did you enjoy it quite a bit, you know, or did you do it for a while?
It was excellent. I loved doing it.
Okay. And moving over here, obviously he's very, you know, focused on the game here. Now, Abby is involved with Destination Imagination. Tell us what that is.
It's a creative problem-solving challenge. You form a team of up to 7 students, and you get this challenge with all these specifications. There's drama and there's mechanical, and you then go and compete against other teams who have the same challenge. Mm-hmm. My team, 2 years ago, we won the New Hampshire States. Well, we came in second place, but we got to go to the global competition in Tennessee, and we met teams from China. It was really fun.
Sounds like you had a good time. Now, Margaret, over here, you're involved with construction, you know, which is interesting for a female.
Yeah, I took a construction class at my school. It was a brand new class, and I was one of 2 girls, but we made 3 gazebos that we're sharing with other schools in our district, so it was fun.
And you're involved, you like a little farm over at your house, right?
Yep, chickens, pigs, cats, and pumpkins.
And we won't say what happened to some of the pigs because, well, but they were good eating, I understand. Anyway, let's get back to the game. This is your team from Merrimack Valley High School.
And there they are, the pride of Merrimack Valley. And right now, halfway through the game, they need to have a good round going. They're going to try it right here in the 62nd round. In this round, we ask each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We give them 10 points for every correct answer. We'll even bonus them 10 if they get them all right in under a minute. So, again, the team that trails does choose first. So, Merrimack Valley, you can choose, and Newell, you can talk it over with everybody. Choose between planet perplexity, a picture is worth 1,000 words, or animal characters. Planet perplexity, a picture is worth 1,000 words, or animal characters.
We'll take animal characters.
All right, let's go with animal characters. And Newell, again, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. Name the well-known animal character described by each of the following. Start the clock. 1877, horse first named Darkey.
Black Stallion.
It is Black Beauty. Monkey always rescued from scrapes by the man with the yellow hat.
Curious George.
Correct. Honey Bear wearing a shabby hat and yellow Macintosh.
Smokey the Bear?
It is Paddington. Christopher Robin's friend who began life as Edward Bear.
Winnie the Pooh.
Correct. Pig friend of Charlotte A. Cabot-Etka. Thank you. Peter Rabbit's cousin whose adventures make up another book.
Briar Rabbit?
It is Benjamin Bunny. Paul Bunyan's powerful helper able to take curves out of a crooked road.
Blue Ox.
Yes, they'll take that. Klondike half-dog, half-wolf that ends his days in California.
Beowulf.
His White Fang. Stuffed rabbit magically turned into a real rabbit.
Pass.
It is a Velveteen Rabbit, and judges, they get 4 out of 10 on their 62nd round, so we're going to put 40 points onto the scoreboard for them and go over to Hollis-Brookline for Planet Perplexity, or A Picture is Worth a Thousand Words.
We'll take Planet Perplexity, please.
Well, let's
go with
the Planet Perplexity. Again, Joe, you talk to everybody, but I take your answer as the team's answer. Identify each of the following planets. Start the clock. Planet name for the ruler of the sky and heavens in Greek mythology.
Jupiter.
That is Uranus. The red planet named after the Roman god.
Mars.
Correct. Planet name for the Roman messenger of the gods.
Mercury.
Correct. Planet name for the Roman god of the sea.
Neptune.
Correct. A lesser planet name for the Roman god of the underworld.
Pluto.
Correct. Planet named in honor of the Roman goddess of love and beauty.
Venus.
Correct. Planet name for the king of the Roman gods.
Jupiter.
Correct. Planet with the most visible rings first observed by Galileo.
Saturn.
Correct. Either of two planets with no natural satellites.
Venus.
Or Mercury. Correct. Planet closest to Earth, sometimes called its twin.
Venus.
Well done, judges. 9 out of 10. 9 out of 10 on their 62nd round. Well done. That brings us to the end of round number 3. Hollis-Brookline still holding on to that lead they got back in round number 1. So now we head into our 4th and final round. 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way, teams. Good luck, and here we go. Identify the 19th century frontiersman who founded Lawrenceburg, Tennessee. Dan of Hollis-Brookline. I can repeat it from Merrimack Valley. Identify the 19th century frontiersman who founded Lawrenceburg, Tennessee, served on its first commission, and according to the song, went to Congress to fix up the government before dying as a hero at the Alamo. Abby?
Davy Crockett.
David Crockett is correct for your 10 points. Identify the term for a water spout in the form of a fantastic creature that adorns many Gothic cathedrals. Dan of Hollis-Brookline.
Gargoyle.
Gargoyle is correct. Which term beginning with L designates the absolute brightness of a star as compared to Patrick of Hollis-Brookline?
Luminosity.
Luminosity is right. In which year ending in 0 after the Civil War was the 15th Amendment to the Constitution ratified on February 3rd, guaranteeing that a voter cannot be denied a ballot because of race? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
1870.
1870 is correct. Now we want you to identify the 1984 Heisman Trophy winner from Boston College, Dan of Hollis-Brookline.
Doug Flutie.
We don't have to go any further. Doug Flutie is right. The father of former POW Jessica Lynch said that, contrary to reports, she never suffered from memory loss. What word specifically designates memory loss? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Amnesia.
Amnesia is correct. Which one of our state capitals is named for an explorer who was a prisoner in the Tower of London for 13 years? Dan of Hollis-Brookline.
Raleigh, North Carolina.
Raleigh is right. Well done for another 10 points. During her visit in Rome in 1997, Secretary of State Albright ascended the stone stairs to the 16th century Piazza del Campidio, a square designed by which artist, best known for his paintings on the ceiling of the Vatican Sistine Chapel? Dylan of Hollis-Brookline.
Michelangelo.
Michelangelo is right. We have about a minute and a half to go in our game. What former ward attendant in a mental hospital wrote One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest? Dan of Hollis-Brookline. Merrimack Valley. His name was Ken Kesey. A vocabulary game to help older people exercise their minds, which some believe may prevent memory loss, is being marketed by a doctor specializing in the care of the elderly. Which word beginning with G designates such a physician? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Geriatric.
Judges, will you take that? They're going to take it for the 10 points. What does TWP mean as used on the Delaware traffic sign entering TWP of Harrison? Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Township.
Township is right. Now identify the English philosopher whose essay concerning human understanding describes his theory of the mind as tabula rasa, void of all characters and ideas. Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
John Locke.
John Locke will have another 10 points for you. Identify the Greek poet who wrote the best-known epics in Western literature. Patrick of Hollis-Brookline.
Homer.
They being the Iliad and the Odyssey. In which U.S. state were rubber gloves used for the first time in surgery at Johns Hopkins Hospital in 1890? Margaret of Merrimack Valley.
Texas.
Hollis-Brookline. Dan?
Maryland.
Maryland is where Johns Hopkins Hospital is located. That is correct. For 10 points, on March 6th, and there's the sound ending our game. Well, Hollis-Brookline got the early lead, and they never eased up tonight as they win the game over Merrimack Valley and advance into our upcoming second round of play. So congratulations to Hollis-Brookline. So we have now one game remaining in our opening round. That'll take place in 1 week when the teams from Manchester Memorial High School go against Nashua High School North. That's next week. Manchester Memorial against Nashua High School North. Thanks for watching this week. We'll see you in a week. Goodbye, everybody.